Being a supervillain is hard work. One day you are running away from space police after accidentally blowing up a planet. The next you sign a contract with an Eldritch Horror and have to bring 20 sacrifices on top of a volcano. We may be unfazed by mass extinctions and minor felonies, but we are not immune to stress and worries. Do you know what would really help? A nice, relaxing massage. Everyone loves a massage, except when it costs $300,000. Seriously, get out of my face! Why would I pay that much for a piece of junk when I can build it myself for $30?
Are you aware that you can pay that much to get a massage from someone trained, instead of wasting 3 weeks assembling and programming a robot that will probably come out terrible as usual?
Are you insane? That would mean getting touched by a peasant! Ew! Gross! My fellow humans, I bid you welcome! Let me show you how I spend my salary and my free time. But I'm sure it's worth it. Can you tell I'm actually excited to test this monstrosity? This is so stupid it hurts my brain. Anyway, I want to be done with this interview quickly, and I can already hear you screaming, "My lord, please give us an unnecessarily in-depth showcase of your latest creation." And worry not, my child, ask and you shall receive. Let's go! Bah! This is a complete schematic of the machine, generated by a software because I have absolutely zero idea what any of these funny lines mean. But I really like this squiggle over here. I actually took 2 courses on electronics in university, but they were so excruciatingly boring that I completely removed every single memory I had about them. Great job, educational system! In case you're wondering, my building process is just connecting wires together at random until something cool happens or something catches on fire. See this serious and proper engineering visualization of the circuit? Blah! Garbage! This is much better, it's colorful and tidy and pleasing to the eye, and oh my f***ing god! Is this really how it turned out in real life? Remember kids, each time you cable manage like this, a tech tips man somewhere in the multiverse gets diarrhea. Anyway, let's forget about aesthetics, what really matters is function! Oh no! What really matters is functionality, and somehow that is even worse. First up, the Arduino is connected via transistors to a couple of automotive LEDs, powered by what we scientists call a shit ton of batteries. Up here we have an infrared receiver that, surprise surprise, receives infrared signals from a remote. The signal goes bing bing plim plong in a microcontroller that spits out the commands for our 3 main components. This chunky boy over here is a thick servo motor, powered by an equally thick power supply. Is this oversized? Yes, because it moves a tiny arm made of PVC pipe and 3D printed components. But what does the arm do? Thank you for asking! For starters, it holds the end of a tube that runs straight to a pump inside a reservoir filled to the brim with massage oil. The pump is connected to a relay that is controlled by the Arduino, so that whenever the algorithm feels that the situation is not moist enough, it can squirt directly from the top of the pole on the body of the client. On this side we have a second relay that activates a battery drill. Could I have used a high-torque DC motor? Sure! Do I have one? No, so I hacked this poor thing. When powered, the drill spins a flexible shaft that again reaches the top of the arm, where it's connected to a pair of gloves filled with dense foam that will perform the massage. Everything clear? Great! Let's see what will explode this time, because, you know, things breaking is just a cliche at this point.
Ah, it's Friday night after a long week of work! And by work I mean trickery and other misbehaviors. My belly is full of nice food and I reckon I really deserve a good massage. So let's get naked! Now I just have to lay down, select a mode on the remote and relax. Ah!
Perché non sta funzionando il trapano?
Perché non sta funzionando il trapano? Oh, basta! Piattala!
Oh no! Che cazzo è successo?
Take, non lo so, 40.
Sembra che mi sono pisciato addosso. Perché non funziona?
Take 800.327.041.
Uccidetemi.
Ti prego.
Minchia, mi ha lavato! What the f***? Perché?
Well, that was disappointing. From now on, when people ask me what is the difference between your channel and the ones of the other makers, I will reply the success rate tending to zero. One day I will build something that actually works, but this is not the day. God, this channel is awful. Thanks for sticking with me, despite everything. As always, if you want to show your support, please don't. Go subscribe to someone more deserving. If you wish, take a look at these other random videos. It's pretty much guaranteed you will see me fail at something. See you next month. Take care.